Welcome to Entrepreneurship Tuesday right here on Y in the Morning at Y254 channel, is where you can find us across all our social media handles. At Michelle Oshiro is where you can find me across all my social. In this particular session, we dive into an interview that looks at the office supply sort of kind of business. And in studio, I am joined by George Silvanjue, who is a professional accountant and also the co-founder of CityLink Business Solutions. Thank you very much, George, for creating time to be with us.
Thank you. You're very,
very much welcome, George. Very much welcome. One thing about you, George, is that your bio is one of, like, there's a lot that you do. So yeah, apart from being the co-founder of CityLink Business Solution, what else does George Silvanjue deal with?
Okay, basically, okay, I'm a professional accountant. I work as an accountant, chief accountant of Ernst Kenya Limited. I do other kind of a business, like I own an audit firm whereby I do some assignment like forensic audit, a special assignment. Also have my, okay, we have a lot of clients whereby I advise them financially. I'm a finance analyst also. So I advise them on where to invest and how to invest.
Amazing. So this particular conversation that you're going to have, it's a bit of everything. We're looking at investments, we're looking at the accounts, and we're also looking at the office supply business. So you definitely, guys back at home will agree with me that your background, you have a very rich educational background.
Exactly.
So for someone who's watching this conversation and they want to get into the supply sort of kind of business, what kind of educational background does one need?
Okay, somebody does not need the kind of educational background to be in this kind of a business. You only want to, what you need to do is to do a due diligence in the market, and you need to know where there's a gap. Okay, many a times there's these guys who come to business, but they don't do what we call the due diligence in that market. But it's a very important thing. First, you identify where there's a gap. Because you need to be unique in that business. And what makes you different from the others is that uniqueness and that kind of a product which you are providing. The cost of it, how you're costing it, is very much important. So as a young person, as young guys who are about to, who are new graduate, maybe you come to the business and make something out of it, they need first, okay, also you need to be very patient. You need to be very patient. You need to check on your capital, what you have, and what can be able to start, what kind of a business you can be able to start. You can start with a very small capital, even 5,000 you can be able to start for the office supply, even 3,000, even 1,000. You can start selling clothes, small, the children's clothes with 1,000. And from that 1,000, what matters is your margins. If you're buying maybe 10 calls from with 1,000, and you resell those calls maybe you're making a margin of maybe 20%, you can be very sure at the end of your sales you have already made about 200 shillings. You reinvest that 200, you buy 12 calls, you resell, I'm very sure you have crept maybe to 2,000. It also it's also good to be able to invest whereby you can own fast moving items. If you're not selling a lot of items, it's good to invest where you have very fast moving items, like the children's clothes. In the surprise of the office surprise, it's good to invest on the like stationery, the fast moving items, like the printing papers, the banners, the notebooks, biros. Those items.
The items that are actually on high demand.
High demand in the offices.
Alright.
Yeah.
Interesting. I'm so much excited when it comes to this particular conversation we're having, because it's just a little bit of everything, investment when it comes to accounts and now actually the business aspect of it. So let's look at, I'll take you back to still investments.
Okay.
What are a couple of investment opportunities that actually they're in the market space that young people can, you know, take advantage?
It's not a must to have the finance background to invest in the derivative market or the forex exchange market.
Okay.
It's a very interesting thing. If for instance, it's like gambling, but it's not gambling. To read the graph, you need only to master the graphs. You predict. It will just come automatic. Either it will go up or in a binary. There is what you call the binary. There is what you call the option market. There is what you call the, both of them, they are derivative market.
Okay.
They are very profitable. Also, another venture you can, the young guys they can be able to venture in is the daycare. If you have a house, even if it's a rental house, as a young person, young ladies, you can be able to maybe you can start your own daycare. You don't need a lot of money to start a daycare. There's another opportunity. You can sell clothes.
Mm-hmm.
That's another business opportunity. You don't have to have a kiosk for you to sell clothes. You can sell them online as a young person. Just from graduate, you come and you start your own business.
So many opportunities.
You just
minimum
need to look.
Capital required.
The minimum capital required, you need 2,000 to start a clothes selling business.
Okay.
You need a phone, you have a smartphone. You can be able to post your shoes, maybe clothes. You can start a printing business. You only need a printer in your house, at the comfort of your house, at your bedroom, and then you start out. I remember when I was in the campus, because I've been campus for most of my years, because I've been to campus for 4 years, I've been to another campus for another several years, I've been to another campus for another several years. So when I was in the first of my first 4 years in the campus, I used to do a business, typing business and printing business. I used to write for people business plan. That was my business then. I used to make a lot of money from it. We used to cooperate with my twin sister. I have a twin sister. So we used to do to interlink because she was best in typing. So I'll take the work and then I take it home for her to type. And by the following day, I hand it over and I bring the money and then we share. So as a young boy, the basic point here is don't sit at home or go to the base and take mirror and then you say that the government is not offering the business opportunity or it's not offering job. Most of the guys, the young guys, who are still in the school, they think that maybe immediately after school you get a white collar job. They focus on that. They don't understand that currently in Kenya, the statistics show that about 60%, the unemployment rate is about around 60%. Very few guys are employed. So as a young person, think of how you can employ yourself and provide employment to others.
Right. And it's very good actually we have in this conversation because most young people, we are held bent to the aspect of capital. We need capital to start. And in most cases, we never get like the enough capital because we will always create another excuse or just have a business plan that requires way more when it comes to capital.
Basically, the capital, you don't have to start with 100 million. You don't have to start with even 10,000. There are some opportunities which are there, which only need you are. Like for instance, I can give you an existence. You have started media. Like a media student, what immediately comes from the college or from the university, he can start his own business, photography. I think there's production about the photography.
Oh, yes,
you can start
YouTube.
Taking people photos, mm-hmm. and you make something out of that. You don't need a lot of money to start that kind of a business. As an accountant, I can be able to tell you because I've been an accountant for the last, I think, 8 years.
Mm.
I've been a chief accountant for about 6 years. Now, one thing I've come to note that the graduate, basically the education is not offering the enough skills. When this graduate come out, then they might be economically upright, but in terms of work, they are zero. So one thing they need to associate themselves with guys who are mentors, who knows how these things are learned.
Okay.
For instance, I can give my own story that when I created my CPA back in 2012, lucky enough, I was never tarmacked, so I was hired immediately in 2013 as an assistant accountant. I was zero, but with that passion and the desire to learn and invest my in my academic, I've come to learn a lot of many things, and I can be able to be there. I cannot compare myself now and by then. I have a lot of grind, a lot of rivals. I receive calls after calls, and when I get one client, I get many other more from that one client.
Oh, rivals, because consistency,
my job is fine.
Okay, so let's look at your company, the CityLink business that you offer the office supply of products. So what exactly do you guys do in detail?
Okay, in details, basically the CityLink business solution, we started back in 2016 with a part number by the name of Lucas. There is also another accountant, he's also an auditor. So in this business, we have two partners. It deals with the marketing and the securing the tender, those tenders, getting those kind of a business. On my side, I deal with the side of the ensuring that we have enough capital to ensure once we get a tender, I can be able to refinance the tender. In some cases, we have a problem whereby we can get a tender for maybe 10 million. And maybe I don't have that kind of a I cannot be able to manage, because once you walk to a bank, there is no bank which is willing to give you that kind of a money to be able to finance that kind of a business. Basically, business settling business, it deals with small tenders like ranging between 100,000 and 500,000. But it intends in the next maybe 5 years to be dealing with even more bigger tenders, which are ranges maybe from 1 million to 5 million.
Okay, and for someone who's watching this conversation and they would like to get into this sort of business, by the way, you know, they have a tender and they just want to be in that space of, you know, supplying products in offices. Mm-hmm. So what is the best ways on how does one go about, you know, starting an office supply business?
Okay, one thing you need to do as if you're a business person, you need first to ensure that, to first look at that market, stand the market, look what is that market need. Go to those offices, try to ask what kind of things, like the bylaw pen, the printing papers, and that, and that, and that. Then you capitalize on that. Then you know what kind, for instance, the requirement, you need to have, for you to be able to supply, you need to have money at hand, because sometimes you only get a phone call from maybe your client, say that by noon, you need maybe like 150 lien papers. You need 100 ream papers. You need like 50 papers. You need that. You need to have that kind of a. You need to have that kind of a range.
All right. So, and how does one in this particular space of business? How do you come up with looking at the stock and stand out in the market space? Because I'm so sure there are a couple of companies that do the same when it comes to office supply.
Yeah, it is a competition in the market. Everywhere there's a competition. But for how you brand yourself and the quality of your product and the costing of a product, the pricing of your product is very important. So just do your due diligence. Try to find out how the others they are faring the market in terms of their pricing and in terms of the quality of those what they supply. Then you capitalize on the quality and the pricing. I'm very sure you outweigh them by your pricing, because most of the tenders, especially to the government, they are overpriced. Mm-hmm. Don't go to overpriced. If it's a margin, if for instance, if a bio pen, it costs about 10 shillings, mm-hmm. don't go to say it is cost 80 shillings. Don't go to quote about 100 bob. Just quote fairly, just quote 20 bob.
And how does one go about, you know, estimating the demand for an office good and run with the opportunity? Because again, in this particular space, as you said earlier, your clientele, they will always go for the fair price.
Yes. Yeah. Basically, first you need to have connection. Not that to a big connection, but you need to be asking, you need to interact with people, you need to interact with your friends. You need to interact with them. You walk into an office, say, introduce yourself, say that you are wearing this and that, and have a price list. Give your client the price list. Like, always keep updating that price list, because sometimes you might quote a price, maybe come like the, for instance, last year. You find that dollar at the moment dollar is 110. At the moment, it's 110, 111. By then, it was 105, 104, 100. So it means that the product in the market, they have been affected by that, because most of this product, we import them from outside the country, and we use the dollar to import them. So you need to be very careful when you are quoting, and even the kind of surprise you are doing.
Right. And when it comes to outsourcing the products, do you work as just a company, or do you team up with other members?
Yeah, we team up, because in a catering business solution, we have hired professionals like the designer who designed the banners. Anything that you need, banners and what. Okay, like some company, they ask for us to design for them, maybe like logos, the business card. That one, okay, of course, I'm not a graphic designer, so there's no way I can be able to design. Mm-hmm. So I have to hire somebody to design for me.
All right, fair enough. And as you said earlier on, this is a very competitive space. So how do you guys market yourself or promote yourself better way to just stand out from other competitors?
Okay, so in the way we stand out about the pricing and the quality.
Okay.
We focus most of our product, we focus on the quality. We ensure that the quality we supply is a very, very competitive quality, and also our pricing are a bit fairly priced, not a high pricing. Mm-hmm. Because even if most of the government, when we apply tenders from most of the government offices, we always secure those tenders. Mm-hmm. If it's on a fair ground, we always secure those standards, because our pricing are very much fairly. Our margin are not that big, but with small, okay, don't go for big margin, just go for mini tenders with small margin, and you make money even than the person who is going for a bigger margin.
Okay, so, and what are some of the ways, this is the place where you give us tips, yeah?
Okay.
What are some of the ways that you can actually identify what your potential and also existing client really want, and go for that to make you stand out?
Okay. Most of the needs of this client. As I said when I was starting,
yes.
You need to interact with people. You need to know. You need to read a lot. You need to do a lot of observation. You need to talk to your. You need to walk in those offices. You need to speak to your friends, family members, and everyone. With that, you'll be able to gather a lot of information.
Mm-hmm.
And with that information is power, you can be able to capitalize on it.
Right.
And you'll be able to identify the gaps, maybe the requirement in that office, maybe they need, they always need this and that, maybe they need food, anything, they need that office, and you can be able to know where you can start. Maybe you go to the printing side, you go to the general supply side, and you go to financial advising side.
Okay. Speaking about financial advice, mm-hmm. What couple of financial lessons that are very critical for anyone who wants to get into the supply sort of kind of business?
The financial bit of it in any kind of a business, one thing you need to think of is the capital.
Okay.
You need first to have a range of the kind of a business you are going into. You need to know the requirement of the capital. In that kind of a business. Once you identify that, you start now evaluating the gaps in that kind of a business. And with that, you'll be free to, and then the passion. You need to have a lot of passion, and you need also to be very patient. Because at the start, when you're studying a business, mm-hmm. I remember when I started the audit firm, we pinned the office for more than 2 years without even a single client. Working in, because most of the time I'm not in the office. I'm working, my partner is also working.
Okay.
So there's nobody in the office. So you only rely on the referrals and the friends.
All right. As the chief accountant,
yes.
Because you have a very rich background in accounts, we'd like to find out what couple of ways, or this will be like an opportunity for you, George, to give an advice on when you're starting off a business, what type of financial decision should one make to just make sure that, you know, the company stays afloat and you just don't swindle all the profits.
One thing you need to, when you are starting any kind of, ensure that you are compliant with all the the tax rules with the KRA, ensure that you're compliant, you are filing your taxes on time, because that another thing which maybe young people, they are starting their business, they are not considering that bit of sign. Ensure that you have all the licensing bit of it, if it requires the licensing, like the audit firm require that you have your CPK, you are licensed with by the ISPAC, you have a city council license and that kind of a business. Then the other thing, you need to have a target market, to have a target market where you're going. Because when you're providing, it's different when you're providing the goods and when you're providing the services. With the services, it is as an asset to that business. Because it's that business, when I'm not in that, if those are financial advice, they come from me. Unless I have somebody, I can't be able to hire somebody there to operate for me. But it is idea invested, basically.
All right, so take us through, when it comes to CityLink business, what is your target market, and also what is your niche? What problem are you solving?
Okay, CityLink business, our target market is basically the circles and the banks. We venture much in the NGOs, circles, and the banks. We make a lot of sales and the government. These are government departments. We get a lot of tenders from. We have invested a lot in those kind of target market, because it's easier. Because with the youth, they have they have advantage on the side of the government. When you have that certificate of workable, you get a lot of tenders from the government.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Okay. Let's look at your marketing strategy that you guys are up to it to just scale up your business in 2021.
Okay, 2021, we are targeting. There was a problem in 2020,
yes,
whereby the COVID thing it meant people to work from home.
Very true.
So you see that already has affected us a lot, because in 2020. You cannot get a key school. It's very hard to get the tender for officer price, because guys are working from home. So there's no more printing in the office. There's no use of pens.
So that the industries are all affected.
All the industry,
yes,
like any other industry, were all affected.
Yeah.
So we cannot shy away from that, even as a certain business solution.
Mm-hmm.
In 2021, we focus on I'm hoping that by the end of this year, our turnover should be okay, or our target market should expand. We should be able to expand our target market, even to small offices, so that we can have widen our market. Because we got challenged because of our target market, because most of these government organization, they were not in operation. They were not, even today there are some departments which are not operating. But if I operate with the private firms, they are still in the operation, and it will expand our target market.
Mm-hmm.
Before the end of the year.
Okay. Couple of disadvantages that you're facing in this particular business.
The some of the disadvantages that competition.
Mm-hmm.
Competition is too high. Most of the guys are venturing that market, and also the important items from abroad, like the Chinese guys. Chinese guys, they front the market with a lot of cheaper things.
Mm-hmm.
So if you buy a stock and you stock it in the office, it stays there for maybe several months, you might sell it at a loss.
Mm-hmm.
in due time. Because the Chinese, guys here, they
know. What if they argue it's a, it comes at a fair price?
Yeah, it comes at a fair price. It's a cheap price items. Because, you don't want to make, sometimes you go at a loss.
Mm-hmm.
If you stock something, for instance, you bought some items in January, even to date, you have not sold those items.
Mm-hmm.
It means that the pricing by then and now is something very different. You might decide even to throw them away at a. At least you get back your capital.
All right. And what's the vision looking like when it comes to the CityLink business solutions?
We look forward even to call in some other partners to merge with the other guys to diversify our business. even to, because since we are professionals, as I said, that I'm a finance, I handle the financial side. There's another guy who handles the accounting bit of it.
Okay.
There's a guy who handles the graphic side. So we can bring in somebody, we can diversify, we meet and then diversify the business. Even you can venture into something else.
Okay.
Yes.
All right. So George, yes. I'd like to for you to take this opportunity and give us a couple of tips. Let's say three tips, right, when it comes to getting loans for a business. At what particular time should I go for a loan?
Okay, go for a loan if you are sure of what you are going to do. Don't just go for a loan and then you start thinking of what you're going to do with that money. Ensure that you have already attired what you're going to do with that money. That's the greatest advice I can always advise to it.
You should be sure of what you're actually going to do with the money before you actually have it at hand.
Exactly.
Okay. Thank you very much, George Silva and Jay, for creating time to be with us and talking about matters pertaining the office supply store, kind of a business.
Yeah.
All right, so that is George Silvanjoy, who is a professional accountant and also the co-founder of CityLink Business. So make sure you stay tuned right here on Y in the Morning at Y254 channel, is where you can find us across all our social media platforms. Remember, the hashtag to use is hashtag Entrepreneurship Tuesday at Michelle Ashira, is where you can find me across all my social media handles. And before I actually sign out, and you probably could give us your social media handles.
We only have a number.
Okay,
we only have a number. Uh-huh. Office line number. It is 07.
All right.
86444422.
Okay.
Also, yes. You can use the other number is 0712-521-741. That's my personal number, so you can call me directly.
All right.
And I can give you the details.
There you have it. You can actually call George Silva.
Or you can find us on the Facebook. You can find me on the Facebook at George Silva.
As George Silva. And any question when it comes to matters pertaining accounting, finance, he's going to help you out. So keep that conversation going. Remember, at Y254 channel is where you can find us across all our social media platform at Y254 channel, at Michelle Ashira, Entrepreneurship Tuesday, Y in the Morning. We'll be right back.